today, along with the inaugural program of the 50 of the Mekong Festival, we are also launching the 50-year celebration program from today, which will continue for the next 1 year. Now, up to 21st of January, and on that day, we'll have a big program in Shillong and the district headquarters, followed that again by a number of programs throughout the state. So I just wanted to take this opportunity and this occasion to thank the tourism department for this wonderful festival that has been organized, and I wish it the very best. I also would like to thank the DIPR, which is the nodal agency and the department, for the 50 years celebration of the state and the 75 years celebration of India's independence. So with these few words, once again, thank you very much, and I hope all of you enjoy the Mekong Festival also. I would like to take a few questions if you have any. Thank you.
Can you tell us, this is a repeated question, why festivals amid the financial crunch, COVID, and lot of grievances from the people?
So the state and the economy and the livelihood of the people depends on many sectors. We have a lot of work that is happening in the education department. We're having a lot of work that's happening in the tourism department, in the agriculture department, and in the road and infrastructure departments. And therefore, there's a budget for everything that we do. And if we were to stop the construction of the roads based on maybe some other needs of some other departments, then the road sector would suffer. So therefore, as a government, it is important for us to balance out the work that we do in the economy. Yes, there is expenditure involved in the tourism department and holding these festivals, but obviously there is a calculated outcome and benefit that we expect for the tourism sector, especially after the great difficulty it has gone through in the COVID times. And obviously it will benefit and create a lot of livelihood. So therefore it is important for the government to handle and take care of the COVID situation and other expenditures, yet create the opportunity through tourism also. I remember some time back the press had asked me the same question, that what have you done for tourism and what have you done to relieve the pressure and the difficulties that the tourism sector is facing. So the answer is this, that we are now trying to revive the tourism sector